Okay, nomenclature of complexes according to IPC system. Now you have to write the name of the complexes according to IPC system. So there are some rule. I will tell you the rule. Suppose this is one of the complex NiCO4. When you write the name of the complex according to IPC, first time you have to write the name of the ligand. As I have given the ligands, a table I have given. You should know the names of ligands. Here a ligand is CO. This is called carbonyl as a ligand. How many carbonyl? 4. If 2 carbonyl present, it is called dicarbonyl. 3 carbonyl present, it is called tricarbonyl. Here 4 carbonyl, that's why tetracarbonyl. So the name will be tetracarbonyl. This is about the ligand. First time you have to write the name of ligand, tetracarbonyl. And what is the metal here? Nickel. Tetracarbonyl nickel. And in bracket you have to write the oxidation number of the nickel. I mean the charge of nickel. To find out the charge of nickel, you can find out like this X. Suppose nickel oxidation number is X plus carbon monoxide, it's a neutral compound, you know, carbonyl is a neutral, it do not have any charge. Already I have given in the table which contains charge, which do not have charge. So carbonyl charge is 0 into 4, there are 4 carbonyl, this is equal, outside there is no charge, so equal 0. Ultimately X you will get 0. I mean the charge of nickel is 0 here, that's why you have to write 0, I mean no charge present. So tetracarbonyl nickel 0, like this way you have to write the IUPAC name. But one thing you should know, when you write the IUPAC name, don't use any capital letter. From the beginning you use small letter, and there should be no gap in between the name. You should write in a single word. So this is one example. Similarly, this is one complex CO H2O whole 6. Suppose it contains 3 plus charge outside of square bracket. Now here ligand is water. Water is called aqua as ligand. How many aqua? 6. 6 is called hexa. So you have to write hexa aqua. This is one of the cationic complex outside of square bracket. It contains some positive charge. That's why this type of complexes are called cationic complex. Now to write the name, hexa aqua. I mean 6 aqua present. Now you write the name of the metal continuously. Your metal is cobalt. Hexa aqua cobalt. In bracket you have to write the oxidation number of the metal. Suppose cobalt is X. Water, there is no charge, water. 0 into 6 equal. Bahar ke charge hai plus 3. So equal plus 3. Bahar jo charge hoga, that should be equal to the charge. If there is no charge outside of square bracket, you write equal 0. So X is equal, you will get plus 3. So here cobalt is in plus 3 state, and that plus 3 you have to represent by Roman symbol like this, 3. So hexa aqua cobalt 3. This is the name of this complex according to IPAC system. Now I will tell you another I will consider. Suppose this is one of the complex FeCN6, outside it contains negative charge, 3 minus. This is one example of anionic complex because it contains negative charge outside of square bracket. So here, if you want to write the name, you have to write like this. This ligand is called cyanido. How much cyanido? Hexa, 6. So hexa cyanido. Now there is a rule here. This complex is anionic complex because it contains negative charge outside of square bracket. In case of anionic complex, when you write the name of the metal, then with the name of the metal, you have to add the suffix 8, A-T-E, 8. For example, your metal is nickel, then you have to write nickelate. Your metal is suppose cobalt, then you have to write cobaltate, like this. You have to add the suffix 8. This you apply only in case of anionic complex, I mean the complex which contains negative charge outside of square bracket. So here metal is iron. Iron is called ferret. So hexa cyanido ferret, then Roman symbol, oxidation number you find out the oxidation number. Suppose iron is X plus. This is called cyanide, and cyanide contain minus one charge. Already I have given in table. Into 6, there are 6 cyanide, that's why into 6 equal, outside in contain minus 3, that's why equal minus 3. So X will be plus 3. I mean the charge of iron is plus 3, and that you have to represent by Roman symbol like this. So hexacyanide of ferrite 3. So like this way you can write the IUPAC naming of the complexes. Now another complex, suppose CO NH3 whole 6 Cl3. This type of complex are called salt like complex. Some counter ion is added. Your counter ion is Cl minus, 3 Cl is joined. Now as you know, this counter ion is not the part of the complex, it is outside of square bracket just to neutralize the charge. You know chlorine charge is minus 1, 3 chlorine means 3 minus. Originally, outside of square bracket it contained 3 plus, and to neutralize that 3 plus, 3 chlorine is added here. So that is why originally the complex is cationic complex, that's why anionic counter ion is used. So if you want to write the name, how to write? Here ligand is NH3, NH3 is called amine, there are 6 NH3, that's why hexaamine, hexaamine, your metal is cobalt, hexaamine cobalt. Now you find out the oxidation number, X plus ammonia no charge, this is plus, here chlorine is present, now chlorine charge also you have to consider, minus 1 into 3 equal you write 0, I mean this plus this charge equal 0. So ultimately X equal you will get plus 3. So here cobalt is 3. So like this you can find out the charge. So hexaamine cobalt 3. Now one counter ion is present. What is your counter ion? Cl minus. To write the counter ion, just to write the name of the ion, I mean chloride. Although there are 3 chlorine, don't write trichloride. It may be 2 chlorine, 3 chlorine, 4 chlorine, just to write the name chloride. Have you got it? So like this way you can write the name of the complexes. Now I'll tell you another one. Suppose this is one of the complex, K3FeCN6, like this. Here also counter ion is present. Counter ion is potassium. Potassium, you know, positive ion. That means outside it contain negative charge. I mean this is one of the anionic complex. So potassium contain 1 plus, 3 potassium means it contain 3 plus, I mean outside of square bracket it contain 3 minus charge. Okay, I mean the originally the complex is anionic complex, and that's why when you write the name of the metal you have to add the suffix 8. So since the counter ion is positive ion, here counter ion is negative ion, here counter ion is positive ion, if the counter ion is positive ion, first you write the name of the counter ion, if it is positive ion. That's why I'll write the counter ion first, potassium, like this you write the name. Here chlorine is anion, that's why I have written last, but since potassium is cation as counter, that's why you have to write first, potassium, hexacyanide, this is called cyanide, hexacyanide, since it is anionic complex, again you have to write ferrite. Then you have to write the oxidation number, potassium plus 1 into 3 plus iron suppose X plus cyanide is minus 1 into 6 equal 0. So X you will get plus 3, I mean ferrite 3 ion. Like this you can write the name of the complex. So always you remember, when you have to apply the suffix 8 with the name of the metal, if the complex contain negative charge outside of square bracket, then you write 8 like ferrite. Similarly, if the counter ion is cation, then also you have to apply the suffix 8. So there are two conditions to write the 8 suffix with the name of the metal. If the complex contains negative charge outside of square bracket, and if the complex contains some cation as counter ion, then you have to apply the suffix 8. So like this way, you can write the IUPAC name of the complexes. Here, I have made some gap because potassium, it's a not the part of a complex. Actually main complex is this one, and that's why in this part there should be no gap, and don't use any capital letter. So this is about the process of naming the complex compound according to IUPAC system. Thank you.